monitor the liquid level without getting up from the couch? Now it's real. Today we are reviewing a smart ultrasonic liquid level sensor from Tuya, a compact and accurate device that can measure the liquid level without contact with it from 10 cm to 4 meters. And not only water, it is suitable for gasoline, acids, alkalis, and even hot or cold environments. If you have a water container, a reservoir, a barrel, a septic tank, or even just a watering tank on your site, this sensor will be a great helper. It connects via Wi-Fi or ZigBee, as in my case, and is controlled through the familiar Tuya or Smart Life application, and gives a complete picture right on the smartphone screen. In this video, we will figure out the installation, test it in action, check the capabilities of the Tuya Smart application and the automation capabilities. Yes, of course, we will try to integrate it into Home Assistant. Let's go, it will be interesting. Device specifications. Power adapter, from 110 to 250 volts, suitable for any network. Sensor power supply 5 volts, up to 100 milliamps. Measurement range, from 10 centimeters to 4 meters. Accuracy, plus or minus 2 centimeters. Operating temperature, from minus 20 to plus 50 degrees Celsius. IP65 case protection, can be installed outdoors. Connection, ZigBee version, requires a gateway. There is also Wi-Fi 2 and 4 GHz, no gateway is needed there. Applications, Tuya and Smart Life. The case is plastic, the weight of the device is 250 grams. Device package. It comes in a small cardboard box without various identification marks and other information about the product. Let's look at the device package. First of all, open the instructions. It describes all the options for working with the device quite clearly and in detail, from the first connection to setting up and connecting to a container with liquid. All actions are provided with detailed illustrations. Next is the quality control sign, a small cardboard triangle. There is also a dense polypropylene gasket, with holes for attaching the sensor to the container. For easier installation, there is an adhesive base on one side. We glued the gasket to the container, drilled a hole and fixed the sensor itself. Thanks to this installation method, nothing will spill out through the holes and the sensor. In a separate bag there are 4 self-tapping screws for attaching the sensor to the container. The power supply for the device is in a separate bag. The power supply with a European plug produces 5 volts and a current of 1 ampere. There is an indicator LED, when connected, it lights up red. The cable length is 1 meter, the plug can be called a standard 5 and 5 by 2 and 5. Let's move on directly to the ultrasonic liquid level sensor itself. Before looking at it, let's understand the principle of its operation. You may ask how this sensor works. In short, it works like an echo sounder. The device emits an ultrasonic signal that is reflected from the surface of the liquid in the tank. The sensor detects the reflected wave and calculates the distance to the liquid level, taking into account the signal return time. This is called contactless measurement. The sensor is not immersed in water, but is attached to the outside, on top of the tank, and does not come into contact with the contents. This is especially convenient if the liquid is aggressive, hot or, conversely, cold. After measuring, the data is sent via Wi-Fi to the Tuya or Smart Life application, where you can immediately see the level, set notifications, trigger thresholds, enable an alert at a low level and much more. This approach allows you to control the level of water, fuel or other liquids remotely and without having to open the tank cap every time. The sensor itself is made of plastic painted orange. This is most likely done to highlight the sensor on a barrel or other container so that it is not accidentally knocked down or broken. The sensor itself is round, its diameter is 80 millimeters, and the mounting platform is square. There are mounting holes in the corners. On one of the sides there is a sticker with the technical characteristics of the device. The sensor power supply is connected via a hermetic connection. The cable length is 5 meters. Nearby is an LED indicating the connection status of the device. In the lower, so to speak, working part, we see a touch button, which is needed to put the sensor into pairing mode. Hold for 5 seconds until the status LED on the side of the sensor starts blinking. And right next to it, in the center, we see 2 black sensors that are slightly recessed into the sensor body. These 2 round windows, what are they for? This is not just a design. The ultrasonic sensor consists of 2 separate parts. One window is transmitting. It emits an ultrasonic signal. The second is receiving. it catches the reflected wave. This approach with separate reception and transmission increases the accuracy of measurement and reduces interference. That is, instead of one module listening to itself as in the simplest sensors, there are two independent elements, and this works more reliably, especially at long distances up to 4 meters. In this sensor, correct installation is important. This point is in the instructions, so that the sensor is in the center of the upper part of the tank, so that when pouring water into the tank, it does not block the view of the sensor. Also, the tank should not have a neck, and the minimum diameter at a depth of 4 meters should be at least 2 meters. At a depth of 3 meters, the diameter is more than 1 and 6 meters, and at a depth of a meter, the diameter must be more than 1 and 1 meter. The diameter of the hole for the sensor in the tank should be about 55 millimeters. Since this sensor works on the ZigBee protocol, I need a gateway. If you choose with the Wi-Fi protocol, then you will not need anything except a Wi-Fi router. To add to the Tuya Smart Home ecosystem, regardless of the protocol, hold the touch pairing button on the device until the indicator LED starts blinking quickly. Now open the Tuya Smart or Smart Life application. Next, if you have a Wi-Fi version, just click the plus in the upper corner and select, for example, a Wi-Fi socket. Next, according to the instructions on the smartphone screen, add the device. Everything is simple. Since I have a ZigBee version, I first go to the ZigBee gateway, here it is, and now I click add device. I make sure that the indicator blinks and after a few seconds the device is found and added to the smart home ecosystem. You can rename it or assign a virtual room. I like it when the necessary information is displayed immediately from the main menu of the program. So in this sensor we see the information we need, namely the filling of the tank. Now it is 61%. Let's go inside the sensor plugin. At the top, we see a virtual column of tank filling. Now the filling level is 57%. And on the left side, we are shown the following information. Liquid level ratio filling level is 57%. Liquid level depth is 0.16 meters. Liquid level status, normal, if anything, there will be an overflow signal here. If there is little liquid, there will be an alarm about a small amount of liquid in the tank. Power level 5 and 1 volt, the voltage is fine, it is nice that the device monitors this. The time of recording the values is displayed at the bottom. Conclusion, the level is average, the sensor did not work, everything is stable. Perhaps the tank was just filled. Below we see a graph of the filling of the tank in the context of day, month and year. Let's say we switch to day and see that here in a few hours the liquid column has dropped. It is convenient to analyze the consumption and filling of your tank. There is also a history of triggering configurable alarms. Here we see that there was an alarm about a low liquid level and then about a high level. All these parameters are configured in the settings. Here we can set the following values. Set max, by default 80%, this is the level at which the alarm, too high level, will be triggered. The next parameter set mini, by default 20%, this is the alarm, too low level, it is important to set the installation height parameter correctly. By default, it is set to 5 meters. Let me change these parameters for the following tests. I will set the maximum level to 90%, the minimum I will set to 10%. And here is an important parameter, data on the height of your tank. Since the sensor cannot technically calculate how many liters it needs the height parameter. The following parameters do not apply to this model. But I think that there are other models with a built-in relay models for connecting external devices. Here we see the following settings. Automatic pump control can be enabled so that the system itself turns on/off the pump. Pump mode, filling or draining. Relay switch, a relay that controls the pump, switching the operating mode. The maximum liquid depth is 0.35 meters. In fact, 5 meters is the maximum level that the sensor sees. All alarms, trigger limits and even pump automation are all configured directly in the application. That is, in the future, you cannot approach the equipment at all, everything is already smart and autonomous. At the time of the review, there were no updates. ZigBee module version 1013, MCU version 1.0.0. Let's check what we have with the possibility of automation, since this is the main point of operation of devices in a smart home. And since we have a sensor here, it will act as a trigger, that is, if conditions. If the water level has fallen below 20%, then turn on the pump. Or if the water has risen above 80%, then turn off the pump. But as we saw in the settings, there may be sensors with built-in relays to which various relays or pumps can be connected. Therefore, in the future, the automation system may change. We create a new automation, select our sensor. And here we see quite a lot of if conditions for triggering. Relay switch is information about the built-in relay, if any, on or off. Power level shows the power level of the device. It can be useful to monitor the presence of power in the outlet and start the appropriate automation or display a notification on the smartphone screen, a convenient trigger for monitoring the presence of 220 volts in the network without smart relays. Example, if the voltage is less than 3 volts, send a notification to the phone. Liquid level status is a simplified trigger for the current state, normal, alarm is low or high liquid level, or the sensor is not detected, sensor error. Liquid level depth is the absolute depth of the liquid level, usually in centimeters or meters. This is the main value for precise automation. For example, if the depth is minimum 0.5 meter turn on pumping, liquid level ratio is the filling in percent. You can set, if less than 30%, turn on the pump or open the tap, if more than 95%, turn off. Installation height, sensor installation height above the bottom of the tank, usually set manually during calibration. Does not participate directly in automation, but is important for accurate measurements. Liquid maximum depth, maximum possible liquid depth, also set manually so that the sensor can correctly calculate the percentage of filling. Pump mode, pump operation settings, automation based on pump operation if it is connected. Auto pump control, automation using the current pump operating mode, manually or automatically. But I think the main parameters in automation will be the following. Liquid level depth. Depth, current depth, liquid level ratio, percentage of tank filling, liquid level status, filling level, low normal high. All this can be used to automatically turn the pump on and off, open or close the smart tap, send notifications or run other automation scenarios.
First, let's check the integration via the Tuya cloud server. Restart the integration. Go inside and find our device. ME201Z level sensor. Go inside the device plugin and what do we see? It's not supported. ME201Z level sensor unsupported. It's a pity. Maybe it's just a new product.
Let's connect this sensor directly to the Home Assistant server via ZigBee2MQTT. After connecting the sensor to ZigBee2MQTT, it immediately pulled up without any problems. It appears first in the list of devices. The icon is a barrel, which already hints that it's related to liquids. The name is still technical, but it can be easily changed. For example, call it sensor under barrel, so as not to get confused later in automations. Manufacturer, Tuya, model, ME201WZ. Everything as stated. And here's an important point, the signal level, LQI. Here it is 61, which is very okay. It means that the sensor catches the network normally, there are no problems with reception. But it does not show the charge, well, it is logical, it has external power supply. No batteries, so the charge level is not displayed. In general, everything is connected, identified, works. You can proceed to setting up logic and automation. When we click on the device, its card opens. Here is all the detailed information. We see that the device type is N device, the ZigBee model is TS0601, and the ZigBee manufacturer is underscore TZE284 underscore Q8RBJ. This is like an internal technical name. In the description, water level sensor, that is, this is really a water level sensor, not some kind of universal module. The support status is green, it says, supported, which means that ZigBee2MQTT recognizes it and can work with it, this is good. The power supply is indicated as battery, but there is a question mark next to it. ZigBee2MQTT does not know what it works on. Although in fact, we have external power, from wires, so the question is logical. Availability, currently disabled, but this is temporary. As soon as the sensor gives data, the status will change. The main thing is that the interview was successful, that is, ZigBee2MQTT received all the necessary parameters. The picture is custom, you can change it to something of your own. Although by default there is already such a pixel barrel with a sticker, it is also informative. What the sensor shows, liquid depth 4.94 meters. This is the current liquid depth that the sensor sees from the set tank depth level. As we have already seen with the application settings, it counts from the specified height value. Counterclockwise arrows button liquid level percent null. But this is the percentage of filling, but it is null now, because the base is not set. The sensor does not know how much is considered full. We configure this a little lower. Liquid state, also null. The level state is normal, small, large, but without specified boundaries it cannot calculate it. This is also fixable. Configurable parameters, max set slash mini set. Max set, 80% maximum level after which you can signal, full tank. Mini set, 20% minimum level at which it is already worth giving the signal, time to top up. These are exactly the percentages of the specified range that need to be set lower. For now, they are working idle. As soon as we determine the installation height and max depth, everything will fall into place. Installation height, 5 meters. This is the height from the sensor to the bottom of the tank. You have it set to 5 meters, it matches the depth, which means that the tank is most likely just to the brim. Liquid depth max, 5 meters. This is the maximum level to which there can be water. That is, full tank, is also considered 5 meters, logical. Based on these two values, the liquid level percent and the liquid state status will then be calculated. On the state tab, we actually have data in JSON format, the way ZigBee2MQTT sees it. Here's what's interesting here. Installation underscore height is the height from the sensor to the bottom of the tank. Mine is set to 5 meters. Liquid underscore depth is the actual depth of the liquid, now almost 5 meters. That is, the tank is almost full. Liquid underscore depth underscore max is the maximum configured depth, also 5 meters, so that the sensor knows the boundaries. Liquid underscore level underscore percent and liquid underscore state are empty for now. The filling percentage and level state will be here, but they are not active for me yet. Max underscore set and mini underscore set are the thresholds and percentages that I set up to receive notifications. Mine are 80% and 20%. In short, here we see the purest information, without any interfaces, exactly what the sensor sends to the network and with which Home Assistant can already work. Let's do some tests. Although the manufacturer does not recommend that the container have a neck, so I had to cut the bottle a little. The height of the container is 24 centimeters. I set this in the sensor application settings. Now, as you can see, the level is 82%, which I think is true, since the liquid did not completely fill the container. Let me drain the liquid little by little and you will watch the results. To do this, I will leave a smartphone nearby and the video will be slightly accelerated. Now there is about half of the water and, as you can see, in principle, the sensor clearly determines this. Let's now fill the container. Indeed, about a third is left, maybe a little more. Now let's fill it and see how the sensor will react. As you yourself could see, everything is displayed quite accurately on the smartphone screen. This ultrasonic sensor from Tuya is an excellent solution for automating the control of liquids, barrels, reservoirs, septic tanks or tanks, especially in private homes, in the country or in production. The device does not require immersion in liquid, works contactlessly, accurately measures the level even at a depth of up to 4 meters, and all this, with the output of data directly to the application on the smartphone. The advantages that were especially pleasing: integration with Tuya Smart and the ability to automate directly from the application. There are versions with both Wi-Fi and ZigBee to choose from. Notifications about high and low levels directly to the smartphone. Works from a regular power supply, no batteries are needed. Protection class IP65 can be used outdoors all year round. History of measurements, flow graphs, user-friendly interface. Possibility of automation, turning on the pump, water supply, notifications, etc. Where can it be used? Irrigation tanks in the country or in the garden. Drinking water tanks, septic tanks to prevent overflow. Fuel tanks, diesel, gasoline, industrial tanks with chemicals, drip irrigation systems, as well as water heaters, barrels, any storage tanks. I also like that the sensor can be connected directly to Home Assistant via ZigBee2MQTT, without using the Tuya Cloud. This is a great option for those who want complete autonomy and integration into their smart home system. If you have containers with water or other liquids, I definitely recommend taking a closer look. The device not only saves time, but also allows you to prevent accidents or interruptions in the water supply in advance. You will find all the links to the products in the description under the video. There is also a link to the Telegram group, where you will find not only new products on the smart home system, but also coupons, promotions, and other communication and answers to questions. There are also links to the smart home forum, where all topics are divided into sections for more convenient communication and information search. Please do not forget to like the video if you liked it, and subscribe to the channel so as not to miss other interesting videos about smart and not so smart home systems. All the best to everyone, peaceful skies and goodness. Bye, bye.